peace at last.
Oh, yes, it's a great day.
Oh, here we are. Here, have one.
Lovely, isn't it?
Coffee?
No, toffee.
No, I insist it's coffee.
No, it's toffee. Toffee!
Toffee!
No, no, toffee? It's toffee, toffee, I say. Toffee!
Coffee!
Toffee!
Coffee!
Toffee!
Coffee!
Toffee!
Coffee!
Toffee!
Coffee!
Charge!
Parry's Coffee Bite. The argument continues.
This is the very famous Battle of Parrysburg ad for Coffee Bite, which brought before us the coffee versus toffee argument. The ad was so well received that there were many such similar ads in the same line. The Coffee versus Toffee series of ads were originally made for the Parry's company, a name which should be familiar especially in southern India. Parry's, or rather EID Parry India Limited, is a major player in the manufacture and marketing of sugar and bioproducts. Although they are based out of Chennai, their origin story needs to be told from a place thousands of miles away in Wales. Thomas Parry was born to Edward and Anne of Welshpool in 1768. At the young age of 21, he boarded a ship and 6 months later reached India, specifically Chennai or the erstwhile Madras. Through his affluent contacts, he got the license to trade as a free merchant in Madras. He added several people as partners and tried his hands on many businesses. In 1805, he started a tannery in Leith Castle near Santhome and started exporting boots and army leather goods. But the real turnaround occurred when he joined hands with a partner named John William Dare. Parry and Dare expanded into the business of coffee, spirits, and then later into sugar. Not long after entering the sugar business, Thomas Parry died in 1824. In 1842, Parry's, as it was now being called, set up their first sugar factory in Nellikuppam in the Cuddalore district. From then on, the rise of Parry's was phenomenal. Under John Dare, the East India Distilleries and Sugar Factories Limited, or EID, was formed in London in 1897, for which Parry's became the managing agents. The particular junction in Chennai where the Parry's business got started is now famously named Parry's Corner. The place is an important center for commercial activities such as banking and trading, and also acts as a major hub for the intra-city bus service. Towards the early years of the 1900s, the Parry's sugar business rose to such heights that they were asked by the South Indian Railway to run their own private line to carry jaggery from their plantations to factories. Manufacturing of sugar leaves behind residue which is considered manure for the soil, and this gave Parry's the idea of getting into manufacturing of fertilizers in 1906. Meanwhile, in 1939, the company opened their main office building in Parry's Corner. This building, which was called Dare House, is now one of the most iconic landmarks of Chennai. As Parry's was expanding into other farm inputs, they needed more of sulfuric acid, which was used in the production of fertilizers. Ceramic jars were needed to store the sulfuric acid. So Parry's began making ceramic jars at its single pottery unit in Ranipet, Tamil Nadu. It is this ceramic division that went on to become Parryware in 1952 and which was later acquired by the Spanish company Roca in 2011. Parry's diversified into several industries including Parry's Confectionery. The confectionery business had several famous brands such as Lacto King, Caramel, Coconut Punch and Coffee Bite. In 2004, Parry's Confectionery was sold to the South Korean giant Lotte, and thus Parry's Coffee Bite has now become Lotte Coffee Bite. In 1981, Parry's was taken over by the Murugappa Group of Companies, and the iconic Dare House now serves as the headquarters of the Murugappa Group. Today, their agro business is the most significant pillar in the Murugappa business empire, contributing to about 50% of the group revenue. It is indeed interesting to see how one man's actions could impact the future of several others. This makes us wonder, what would have happened had Thomas Parry not taken that ship to Madras?